I'd like to introduce our Executive President and Provost, Dr. Tom Enneke, who's going to give a welcome this morning.
I'm going to try and use this lapel mic. It sounds like it's working. I think George is giving me a promotion. He's actually the Vice President. But on behalf of President Eleanor, I'd certainly like to welcome all of you here to Marian for this Sigma Zeta convention. And I'm going to make it difficult for you because I'm going to be walking around.
I'm used to it.
It's kind of nice. I got something. Right? I didn't expect the gifts. And there's a t-shirt in there, too, so I always use another t-shirt. People would say that I always show up when there's food or gifts, so that's why I'm here. I know you had some social activities last night, hopefully you had a good time. I think there were some other things that went on last night, so you probably got welcomed yesterday. I saw some poster presentation things, I haven't seen them yet, but I saw some signs that said this way for the posters, and so I'm hoping to be able to check out some of those sometime later today as well. So this is the official welcome. So welcome. Welcome to Indianapolis. I know that some of you came from pretty far away. Somebody said there was a 20-hour drive involved for a group from Texas. So that's tough. I just drove 10 hours to Sioux City, Iowa for our Women's National Basketball Tournament. And 10 hours was long enough. 20 hours. You have my sympathy with that. I am the Executive Vice President and Provost. My academic background is engineering, so certainly I have a fondness for science. I'm certainly excited to have you come here for your national convention. Thanks to Joyce and Steve for putting our group together about 5 years ago, and now we've grown to over 50 members, maybe close to 60 members today. I heard there are 15 chapters here, so that's great, about 150 students. And others, and so welcome to all of you. I'm also glad to say that one of our Board of Trustee members is going to be your keynote speaker tonight, Raul Zavaleta, and that's really appropriate. Raul's an engineer. He's actually spent a large part of his career as an entrepreneur promoting science in the community, which is basically the theme of your conference here today. Certainly with our value, one of our Franciscan values of responsible stewardship, we are also looking at promoting science in the community, practicing what we preach. We have faculty members in our science areas that are involved with green chemistry. We have faculty members that are very involved with Ecolab. If you get a chance, wander around. The Ecolab is a natural preserve area that's just to the north of us here toward 38th Street. Again, we're just minutes from downtown. You probably already know that. And we're kind of like this little island of green space, very close to downtown. We have probably thousands, I think that's literally true, thousands of K-12 students that go through our Ecolab every year. We're proud of that, we're happy about it, and it makes students aware of the environment and turns them into scientists just like you. It might take them 10 or 12 years to get there, but they're going to be just like you, and they're going to sit in these seats, or hope they sit in these seats. At Marian, we're also a community of scholars, we're a community of learners, we've got a vision that we're trying to provide an educational opportunity to our students that transforms them and then allows them to transform society. Within all of our programs, we have threaded a strong liberal arts core. We have a lot of professional programs here. We have a business program, a nursing program, education programs, of course, the College of Osteopathic Medicine. But all of those have threaded through them this liberal arts tradition, this Catholic Franciscan tradition. That tradition is one of research. It's one of questioning, it's one of critical thinking, it's one of forming conclusions based on facts, just like you do, not opinions. We want every graduate that graduates from Marian to be able to think critically, to act logically, to communicate effectively, and to live ethically. Those are the four big things we're trying to get out of our students. But we also want our students to develop a passion for learning. We know we can't get it all today, we know we can't get it all in 4 years. We know that the world is going to change around you, and you have to have that passion for learning, passion for continuing to learn. We want our students, and I'm sure you do it as well, to explore leadership, service opportunities. You have to continue, all of us have to continue to grow as scholars and as people. You need to be prepared not only for your first job with a skill set that gets you a first job, but you have to be able to have an education that then will allow you to be a collaborator, to be able to work with others, a synthesizer, to take processes and apply it to different areas, and then an adapter. We all have to be able to embrace change. Change happens all around us all the time. Some of those changes, we would like to be able to tell you what those are going to be, but we don't know. If you talked about things 10 years ago and where the world is today, you can't predict that. So you have to be flexible. You have to be adaptable. Science will help you do that. Certainly, there's research supported by the American Association of Colleges and Universities that's identified high-impact practices that create deep, integrative learning. And many of those are embedded in all of our educational experiences. Starts as freshmen, goes all the way through to graduation. I'm sure you've all had them, right? Writing intensive courses, collaborative team assignments, undergraduate research, like you're doing right now. Certainly, that's all important. We also have to have group learning, intensive experiences like internships, experiential learning, nursing clinicals, engineering co-ops, student teaching. You're probably all going to be in senior capstone courses. All of those come together to create your total educational experience. I want to tell you a little bit about Marian, just because you're here, and I'm excited about it. It's an exciting time here. We've probably been defined by two words in the last decade. I've been here for 12 years, probably been defined by two words, growth and change. Our institution has changed significantly in the last decade. About a decade ago, we had about 1,000 students. Today, we serve about 4,000 students. A decade ago, we had 12 graduate students in education. Today, we have over 1,000 graduate students. We're creating a new educators college. You can probably all just take a moment and think about a science teacher that you had at some point in time that sparked your interest in science. I think we all have had one, right? You've got one that you can think of, I'm sure. That science teacher probably didn't just have you memorize facts. They probably did science. They're probably things that you got to put your hands on. You got to try things. That's science. To me, that's science. And I think that's what most of us probably think in here, that's science. I was reading an article in a newspaper the other day, and there was a parent complaining. Not that parents all complain, but it was a parent who was complaining about the I-STEP test. And it said they try and sneak math into science. How can you sneak math into science? They said their daughter was a great reader. They weren't doing well on the science portion because they had all this math in science. Of course you have math in science, right? I mean, you can't do it one without the other. It's part of doing science. It's not a memorization of facts. Over the past 8 years, 10 years here, we've expanded all of our graduate offerings. We now have a Master of Science in Biomedical Science that we utilize as a complement to our Doctor of Osteopathic Medicine program. Hopefully you'll get around to the Evans Center, and I don't know if they'll get to see a tour of buildings, but hopefully you'll get into the Evans Center. The Evans Center is one of the largest buildings we've just constructed on the campus. It's about 50,000 square feet, about 150,000 square feet, about a $50 million building. So we're very proud of that facility. It houses our nursing program as well as our Doctor of Osteopathic Medicine and Exercise Sports Sciences over there as well. So get a chance to roam around that building. We're very happy with that. Even while I'm talking about facilities, I should mention a few other facilities. We've built something new almost every year for the last 12 years. Athletic fields, music building, new science labs, residential facilities. This space right here was just built a couple years ago. Everybody's excited about that because Starbucks is right there, right? Everybody goes to Starbucks. Here, we'll see. I think that might be a Starbucks cup. No, it's not really. That's one of ours. Starbucks cups are bright yellow now, right? That's the pastel colors. This is part of our student center complex, the start of our student center complex. I'm sure you saw construction when you came into campus. Hopefully it's not too disruptive for you. There's construction fences around. We're doing a new home for the Byram School of Business, which is back here by one of the north entrances. We're excited to have a new home for our School of Business. We also are starting a project over here that's a new dining facility, as well as a new recreation space, new arena complex for our students to use over there. So that project should be done not by this fall, but by the fall of 18. This project will be done by January of 18. And I'm sure there'll be another project that we continue to build. We're very involved with the community. When we talk about being involved with the community, if you came down off of 38th Street to the north of us, You passed a school, it looked like a school, it is. It's an elementary school, Cold Spring Schools. We're very involved with that school. We're actually connected now to that school. It's one of the innovative schools in Indianapolis public school system. Our faculty, our students work closely with their faculty and students, and their EcoLab, which is now our EcoLab, butts up against the property there. So we're basically very involved there. From 38th Street to 30th Street is about the footprint of Marian University. So we're small, and still this island right here that we can be happy about. So I don't want to take any more of your time. Enough from me. I'm looking forward to seeing your projects. I want you to have a really good day with us. The rest of the day looked like a pretty busy schedule today. It looks like it runs into tomorrow as well. So enjoy the rest of the day. We got great weather for you. 70 degrees here in Indianapolis. It's going to be fun. So, and safe travels back home. So thanks a lot. Thanks for being here.
Meeting starts at 8:30, correct? And a couple reminders, so you can take a quick break, but a couple reminders. Are there any nominations for the Harold Wilkinson Alumni Recognition Award from any of the chapters? Bob Kistler, the webmaster, and I haven't noticed any of those coming in. They're announced at the banquet tonight. Any nominations from any of the chapters? I think we would still take them up till now, but and three Founders Cup applications. Are there others?
Four.
There's four now. Okay, that's right. Four Founders Cup applications, and then honor awards. Individual chapters can nominate one outstanding member from their chapter for the honor award, and those awards are given tonight. How many have you noticed on the website, Bob?
Didn't count.
I don't know if it's possible, but if you could get us paper copies, that would be nice, because we read them tonight as we heap praise on the people who are given the honor awards before we give them a nice award. And so if they're on the web, I guess we could read them off of our phones or tablets tonight at the meeting. But Maybe just contact me or President Ramelsberg to let us know that you've submitted one, because they all kind of pour in together with the abstract nominations, and I may have missed one or two. So each chapter knows who they've nominated for an honor award. Let me and Ann know, please.
Is there anybody that has submitted an honor award that didn't submit one online? Okay.
Just raise your hand if your chapter submitted an honor award. One. Y'all in the same chapter? Okay. Two. Any others?
I think I saw at least two.
You
so.
Saw two. Okay. Brief break time. We start up at 8:30 with a short business meeting before the presentation. So. Thank you for the welcome.
We are here because of all of you. We wouldn't have a meeting without student members. And student members and advisors that are involved in undergraduate research in the sciences and mathematics. And we're happy and proud that you're all here. I would like to thank especially the host chapter for the wonderful job that they're doing. And I hope that it looks like they've got good weather for us for outdoor activities and so forth. So we start with a brief meeting. And National Officer Reports, start that off. So, Jim Hall, would you like to give the executive?
I'm Jim Hall, I'm the Executive Director of Sigma Zeta. I'm the guy that the request for pins and medallions and new certificates comes to, and I'm gonna pick on Stephanie Neal. Stephanie, wave at us. Stephanie works with me in the National Office, so She fills all the orders and mails them out, and I help keep track of stuff and plan agendas and things like that. So I'd just like to say our organization is thriving. I think we counted up last night, we've added 23 new chapters since 2007. Okay, we're pushing 100 here pretty quick, and that'll be kind of a milestone. In April 5th and 6th, we're adding two new chapters. We've never had a chapter in Florida before. We held our officers and advisors meeting in Tampa, Florida, and we did a little bit of recruiting while we were there, and that seemed to have paid off. So on April 5th, I'll be at Warner University, Lake Wales, Florida, just east of Tampa. And then I'll take my rental car and drive over to Miami, which, poor me, I have to go to Miami, and install a chapter at Miami-Dade College. And that will be Gamma Rho and Gamma, doesn't matter, they've got Greek letters too. So we're adding two new members. I'd like to thank the advisors. It seems like you're ordering things earlier in the semester. It really is not nice to try to place orders in April and then expect us to fill that order before final exam week. I'm a full-time faculty member, Stephanie's a full-time student, and so the earlier in the semester that you students and advisors organize things and get orders submitted, the better. We I think set a record for this point in the year. We had like 385 on the books, new members. We've been having about 800 new members a year the last 4 or 5 years. So 385 doesn't sound like a lot, but about 100 new members. We don't count you as members until we get the money. So we in the week right before spring break, which we had last week, right before this meeting, about a hundred. Payments for about 100 new members came in, so we're up to like 485, and honestly, that's better than usual at this point. So, and I don't think I'll bore you with anything else. Oh, the main thing that Sigma Zeta accomplished this year that we've never accomplished before is the awarding of 22 research awards from 23 applications. So that beats the record by over 10. And raise your hand here if you received a Sigma Zeta Research Award. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, did that money help?
Yes, sure.
All right. So that money comes from all of the the $35 fees that y'all are paying in, and we I think we spend those $35 wisely. My daughter was in lots of honor societies when she was in college. This is the cheapest one. Right, $35. You get a lot for your $35. So anyway, we try to spend your money wisely. So, and I'm just going to put one more pitch in. Students at this convention for 3 or 4 consecutive years said, "How come we don't have any items to buy? Some Sigma Zeta items." And so, I designed these and bags and tumblers and water bottles. 2 summers ago, and in the last 2 years, we've sold like a total of 9. 9, okay? My office is full of these things, boxes and boxes of these things are in my office. People come in my office and say, "What is this?" And so they're a pretty good deal. So they're on sale, okay? They're on sale over there, $15 each. So.
And I can attest that my wife carries the screen bag, and it is the best screen bag she has, and I have a water bottle, and it is the best Honor Society related water bottle. And I use it daily.
So yeah, we brought 20 of each, so you better grab them, they're going fast. I sold one this morning. Oh, you need to let them know when you buy them what chapter you're associated with, because we actually keep track of which chapters purchased what. So, did somebody buy a water bottle this morning? Tumbler? I think there was different young ladies sitting there, but if you bought some, put a tick mark by your chapter name. So anyway, welcome. It looks like a great day, and we got 70, I guess, for this time of year here is wonderful. The zoo, anybody going to the zoo? Yeah, it looks like it's great, so. Thank you.
President-elect, the next report.
Hi, I'm David Satisfied from Road Chapter.
And I'm president-elect, so at the end of this meeting, I will become the next president for Sigma Zeta, taking over from Ann. So basically, my report is that I've spent the year trying to figure out how that job's going to go, and attending the meeting in Florida, and trying to help out as I can, giving away those grant awards. I'm looking forward to a really good convention and a good next year.
And as president, I give a short report also. I'm so proud of all of you. This is a great organization, and you guys are the top students, and we hope that you remember to submit chapter reports, which a lot of chapters have not done yet. So submit your chapter reports. Make sure that if you have an award that you're giving us an update on your research, because even if you aren't presenting this year, we really want to know. And if you are presenting this year and finishing your research that we've supported, we need a final report from you as well. So that's really what I want to leave you with, right? This is about you. We hope that the focus, right, is on your good science and your good mathematics and computer science projects that you and your fellow classmates are doing. And we hope you have fun. This is for you. This convention is for you. Past president.
Yes, I'm Jim Glasgow from Alabama, from Malone University. I've contacted several inactive chapters, and I plan to continue to promote this wonderful honor society in the future. To continue to do that good work. So.
National president.
Hi, I'm David Hahn. I'm the National Treasurer for Sigma Zeta from Alpha Gamma Malone University. So I'm the one that keeps track of the books and also the one that writes the checks. So if you need a check to cover your travel expenses, you know, we base that on mileage, you'll want to see me and get a form that you can fill out if you haven't gotten one of those. Your advisor probably picked one up at the advisors meeting, but I know there are a couple of chapters that just came in today that didn't come in last night. So you can get one of those forms from me anytime today. Get that filled out and get it to me, and I can get you a check by tomorrow, so you can have that on your way home. Okay. Just to let you know how we stand financially, we won't get into too many of the details, but the last fiscal year, which started July 1st, 2015, and ran to June 30th, 2016, we had a total income of just over $34,000. That income comes from student memberships, which was just over $25,000. And then selling of jewelry and merchandise, not so much merchandise lately. And then chapter installation fees and some other donations, but mostly from student memberships. And then our expenses were just over $38,500. So we spent a little bit more than we took in, but that's all right. We've got a little bit of a cushion of money, okay? But what our expenses were, our convention that year cost around just $11,500. So we spent on that. The advisors meeting that takes place in the fall, where we do our most of our business along with our recruiting, that was about $6,000. That was in Portland, Oregon that year. And then we had just over $3,000 in research awards that year. Just to let you know already, this year in the fall, we awarded over $7,000 in research awards. So that amount has gone up. So that's where we stand. We're strong financially. We're carrying around $53,000 in a balance, but it's not like that money is sitting there, right? We have about $35,000 coming in, about that much going out. So that the difference there is kind of our cushion. So again, encourage you to see me if you need reimbursement, and I'll probably tomorrow at some point I'll have a table set up where I'm furiously writing checks for you. Thanks.
Unfortunately, our national publicist is ill and was not able to come to the convention, so we'll skip over the publicist report, but basically what the publicist does is makes the Sigma Zeta, which is the on the website. If you looked, it's got all the reports from the national conventions and abstracts and so forth of the presentations that have gone on. So it's a really good history, and you can search it. It's searchable on the web, so we can definitely, we want to continue having a publicist, so that will be one of the positions that those of you that are advisors that are interested in a position that's fairly permanent might be a good job for you guys. Our national webmaster.
I want to welcome you all. I'm not going to go into a lot of detail. How many chapters or people have used the website? Okay, so, you know, that's more than hands have been raised for anything else. So I think it says something in itself. But really, the website is the tool that we as an organization really use and depend on a lot. Hopefully, it's got the right information. And hopefully, if it doesn't, you're communicating that to us as an organization using the comments or sending us an email or emailing Jim or whatever. So we welcome your input, and we'll have a committee that will take a look at some things on the website for the convention as well. We last night looked at some of the older versions of the website just to kind of see what they look like, and essentially it parallels the history of the development of the internet. So from very, very simple and, you know, textual based to a very nice image based system that has lots of information that's organized hopefully fairly well. How many people have used the Facebook site? Okay, that tells us more as well. typically organizations don't do well on Facebook. We do have like 431 likes, so somebody must be doing it, paying attention, but not everybody. It's not on your main place because it's not part of your social network. How many people have visited the Wikipedia page for Sigma Zeta? Or did you know there was one? So you might look up on Wikipedia and see Sigma Zeta, and where some of the videos and will appear from this convention will end up on a YouTube channel. So we have quite a presence out there with all what at least I've been doing as a webmaster. So hopefully you'll take a look at some of that, and I'm glad you're here.
Hi, I'm Bernadine Cochran. I'm from the Beta Zeta chapter at University of Pikeville. My major job is to take care of the history of Sigma Zeta, but that job is easy because I've got a fantastic director and webmaster to help me take care of that part. And the other job I have is doing the scrapbooks of the conventions, which is up front. I've got a couple of them was done by Harold Wilkinson, who was a historian before me, and the rest of them, you know, I think I've done those. And if you want to look at those, that's why they're here. You can see what's went on at past conventions. So they're up here if you look at, if you want to scan through the books. Don't take them home with you, but you can scan and look at them, okay? Have a great time.
Unfortunately, I don't have the list with me of the chapters that are here, so we'll start with the PI chapter. What I'd like you to do is have one person for each chapter say which chapter you're from, what university, and then how many student members and how many faculty members are attending. You guys want to start?
We're the PI chapter. We're from Milwaukee University. It's in Decatur, Illinois. I think we have about 20 members.
Total members. How many are coming?
We have two right now, but we'll have seven total. They're coming later today because they have months and stuff. But we have one.
Just one class. Stonehill College? Alpha Row?
I'm from Stonehill. It's in Massachusetts, and I'm the only one here at the conference today. And I'm not totally sure how many students we have involved. I think we only have one faculty.
You got a ride from the airport.
Hi, we're from Evangel University. We have approximately 20 members of our chapter, and there are 15 here today.
Wow.
Yes, and we drove from Springfield, Missouri, and that was about seven hours.
Yeah.
It's a nice, good travel.
Gamma Kappa?
Oh, we're from
here, Bud, because we can't hear you in the back.
We're from Bolivar, Missouri, Southwest Baptist. We have about 50 members.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Spring break.
They didn't want to come to Indianapolis for spring break?
They didn't want to have to come back to campus.
Is there anybody from Beta?
They were not able to attend.
They were not able to attend, okay. Beta Zai?
We're from the University of Hockville, and there's just one me and one faculty member here today.
Awesome. Beta Iota?
We're Beta Iota. We're from Bethel University in Minnesota, St. Paul. I think we have six members here, and I guess two faculty members with us. Total members, like 40-ish, 50, quite a few, so.
Sigma?
Sigma Zeta.
We are a Sigma chapter. We're from Orlando Lake University. We have seven members and one faculty.
Alpha Aiden.
Hi, we're from Alva College. We have six members here today and two faculty.
And where's your college at?
Alva College in Michigan.
In Michigan.
Five.
We are from Youth College in Youth, Illinois. We have about 30 members, and four of us are here today.
Nice. Row.
I don't like to sit still, so I don't mind walking.
That's why I'm a faculty member. I never stand still in my classes. I just ignore it.
Hi, we are the Row chapter. We drove a whopping 30 minutes to get here from the University of Indianapolis. We have about 50 members, we have 10 students here at the conference, and we have two student faculty advisors.
Alpha Beta?
We are Alpha Beta from Campbellsville, Kentucky, Campbellsville University. We have about 15 to 20 members at our school, and here we have 8 students, and one tag along, so that makes 9 students, and one faculty.
Awesome. Upsilon? Anderson University? Gamma Gamma?
Hi, we're Gamma Gamma. We're from Concordia College in Moorhead, Minnesota. We have 60 members total. 14 came today, and we have 2 extra students. And 2 faculty.
Alpha Gamma?
Hi, we're Alpha Gamma. We are from Malone University, which is in Canton, Ohio. We have 3 students with us today, and 3 faculty.
And Gamma Eta, our host chapter.
We're Marian, we're obviously from here, and we have about 60 members, so they're kind of roaming, and then we have 2 faculty advisors.
Okay, so you probably, have looked, if you've looked on the website, right, there are committee assignments, and each of you as individuals become part of the national organization when we meet in the convention. And so we ask of you that you go to and help with some of the different things like reviewing the website, audit committee, so forth. So I think I'll list out the committees and then have the chairs of those committees announce the names of the people in the different committees. If not, you can find it on the website, so it's there. Founders Cup Committee. Who's the chair?
I don't have the list, but I think it's written.
Oh, you don't have the list?
Whoever's
on the name tag.
Oh, is it on the name tag? Oh, cool. Okay, so Founders Cup Committee, where do you want to meet?
Over by the fireplace.
Over by the fireplace.
I know. We have two fireplaces still.
Oh. As well. That one. Okay. Auditing committee. Let's meet up front because I'm the chair of the auditing committee. So anybody on the auditing committee should come up front. Honor award committee. There are no students on that, so you don't have to worry about that. The alumni recognition committee. Has anybody submitted alumni recognition?
No.
There are no chapters have submitted any alumni recognition. You might think about students who have graduated that are worthy of this award because it's a very special award that we can give, okay, to our alumni. So, and each individual chapter is allowed to nominate a person, just like the Honors Award Committee. Nominations Committee?
That would be me. Let's see, what errors haven't been taken?
That's been taken. This has been taken.
So we'll meet over here on this side.
Okay. Resolutions Committee?
Resolutions Committee, I'm Dennis Siegfried. We'll meet back by the food.
Yeah. Presentation Awards Committee is all faculty, so the faculty judges will evaluate both posters and oral presentations, and what we've decided to do this year because there are eight oral presentations and 26 poster presentations. We are going to award two poster awards instead of just one. So it'll be the top two posters they get awards and one presentation award. Sure. Okay, just so you know. Website committee?
Bob Kistler. And we'll just meet over by the seal over here.
Okay. Meeting by the seal. National Service Project Committee.
Okay, I'm Wiley. And yeah, we'll kind of meet here.
Okay.
And
then if there's middle.
Yeah, if there's not enough space, we can always trundle to the library.
Okay. Are there any host chapter announcements? Because what we'll do is after the meeting adjourns for the beginning session, then we'll meet with our committees at least briefly before the first talks. I think we'll have time.
Yeah, there's 5 minutes right now.
Okay.
The idea was to have just a
quick meeting.
Would that be too crazy? The first presenter's in 5 minutes?
Okay. Are there any host chapter announcements?
No, we'll give, not at this point.
So why don't we meet really briefly just to find out what your job is for the committees, because there's not much time before the first presenter. And if presenters can come up, they'll be loaded.
They're all loaded and ready to go.
Yes.